Good afternoon, everybody. We're going to start in about 5 minutes. So parents, if you haven't already found a seat, please find one of the empty seats. There's a lot of individual seats. We're going to start in 5 minutes.
Okay, good afternoon, everybody. If we can just start settling down, we'll have a little bit of hush. A little bit of hush. Okay, we do have a few spaces down at the front. If there's anybody who's at the back who hasn't got a seat, there are some seats. And if all of the teachers, can you just look at any spare spaces that you have and fill them from that way. So all the seats should be filled with the children from that way, leaving gaps here, and then we can see where there are some gaps. So can you make sure all the seats are filled? Let's just do a little shuffle. I see space. Fill those spaces. Can I just ask Gia, that whole section, are the children going to fill it? They're going to fill it. And the ones in front, so they need to be saved. Okay. So parents on this side, if you have got poor visibility and you want to move into the middle, please take advantage of that. There is a space. So if you want to move over, then come and fill the space in the middle because the visibility is better. Those spaces again and then leave spaces on the ends if anybody else wants to come and join.
Excited to be here. So the theme of the day cultivating global harmony. We're thrilled to see everyone here gathered in the spirit of unity, understanding, and appreciation of cultures. Tourism not only allows us to explore the beauty of our world, but also serves as a bridge, fostering peace by bringing people closer and helping us find our common ground. Let's begin our journey across cultures, exploring how tourism builds bridges of peace and understanding with a special performance from Intro KB.
Japan is a group of over 6,800 islands in East Asia. Its four biggest islands, Honshu, Hokkaido, Kyushu, and Shikoku, make up most of the country's land. Japan is in an area called the Pacific Ring of Fire, which means it has about 1,500 earthquakes each year. The capital city, Tokyo, is the largest city in the world with over 37 million people. Japan is known for cool technology and companies like Sony, Toyota, and Nintendo, which have changed the world of tech. Japan also has a rich culture. There are specialty ceremonies, exciting kabuki theater performances, and the ancient sports of sumo wrestling. People all around the world enjoy these traditions. Australia is the world's sixth largest country. Its vast island national located in the South Hemisphere, known for its diverse landscape, ranging from deserts, tropical rainforests, and stunning beaches. Canberra is the capital, while Sydney and Melbourne are the largest cities. Yearning for their vibrant cultures and iconic landmarks like the Sydney Opera House, Australia's population predominantly English-speaking. Though it's a multicultural country and significant communities from all around the world, Australia is famous for its unique wildlife, including kangaroos, koalas, and the Great Barrier Reef, one of the seven natural wonders of the world. Australia is also known for its sports culture, excellent in cricket, rugby, and surfing. It hosts major events like the Sydney Open Tennis Tournament.
Thank you.
located in northwestern Europe. It's made up of different countries and can be a bit of a political hot potato. England, Scotland and Wales each have their own culture and identity. The capital of England is London, and it's one of the most influential urban cities, known for iconic landmarks like Big Ben, Buckingham Palace and the Tower of London. The UK has a king whose role is largely ceremonial. The country is run by the government, elected by the people. English is the official language, though regional languages such as Welsh and Scottish Gaelic are also spoken. There are also a wide range of accents and dialects. The UK has a rich history, playing a pivotal role in the Industrial Revolution, which transformed it into a global economic power. Today, it remains one of the world's largest economies, with finance, manufacturing, and services as key sectors. The UK is known for its cultural contributions, from Shakespeare's literature to the Beatles' music, as well as being home to prestigious universities such as Oxford and Cambridge. Traditional British celebrations like Halloween, Christmas, and Mothering Sunday are deeply ingrained in the country's cultural fabric.
Scotland is one of the four nations that make up the United Kingdom. It is located in the north of Great Britain and is famous for its beautiful scenery and landscapes. We have mountains, islands, lakes, which we call lochs, and lots of beautiful rolling hills. The capital city is Edinburgh, which is where the Scottish Parliament is located, but the biggest city is where I'm from, and that's Glasgow. In Scotland, we have three languages. The first one is English. The second one is Scots, which is similar to English, but sounds completely different. And Gaelic, which is a totally different language, only spoken in the Highlands. In Scotland, we have bagpipes, kilts, haggis, and Robert Burns, who is our national poet. Scotland has had many famous scientists and engineers, and Scottish people invented things like the telephone, the TV, bicycles, penicillin, and even flushing toilets. The Alps in the north to the Mediterranean coast in the south, Italy has lots of diverse landscapes. Italy has made significant contributions to art, science, and architecture, with historical figures like Leonardo da Vinci and Galileo shaping global history.
Denmark, located in northern Europe, is part of the Scandinavian region and consists of the Jutland Peninsula and over 400 islands. Known for its high quality of life, Denmark consistently ranks as one of the happiest countries in the world. Copenhagen, the capital city, is a cultural and economic hub, famous for its historic landmarks like the Little Mermaid statue and Tivoli Gardens. Danish is the official language. The country is also a leader in sustainability and green energy, with wind power making up a significant portion of its energy's production. Danish food has also gained global recognition, with dishes like smørrebrød, which are open-faced sandwiches, becoming popular worldwide. Denmark's rich cultural heritage also includes world-famous figures, such as the children's author Hans Christian Andersen and the philosopher and poet Søren Kierkegaard.
Italy is located in southern
Zimbabwe is a landlocked country in southern Africa. Made with amazing wildlife, like the animals you can see at Lungu and Malabar, which are great places for safaris. The people of Zimbabwe can speak many languages, like English, Shona, and Malabar. Shona is a new country. Harare is the capital city and the biggest, 1.5 million people living there. Zimbabwe is also home to Victoria Falls, one of the seven natural wonders of the world. This huge waterfall is the Zambezi River, right on the border between Zimbabwe and Zambia, and people from all over the world come to see it.
Poland, located in Central Europe, is known for its rich history and cultural heritage. With a population of over 48 million, Warsaw serves as the capital and largest city, while other major cities include Krakow, Gdańsk, and Wrocław. Poland has a diverse landscape, featuring Carpathian and Sudeten mountains in the south and the Baltic Sea coastline in the north. Polish is the official language, and the country is predominantly Roman Catholic, with religious traditions playing a significant role in its cultural identity. Poland is a member of the European Union and has experienced significant economic growth since joining in 2004, becoming a key player in Europe. The country is renowned for its contributions to art, science, and literature, with historical figures like Marie Curie and Friedrich Chopin being globally recognized. Polish cuisine, known for dishes such as pierogi, dumplings, and bigos, hunter's stew, reflects the country's agricultural heritage. Traditional festivals such as Easter and Christmas are celebrated with deep-rooted customs, making Poland a culturally vibrant nation.
Libya is home to a significant portion of the Sahara Desert, offering awe-inspiring views of vast sand dunes, rugged mountains, and ancient oases. The capital, Tripoli, blends the old and new with bustling markets, historic mosques, and modern developments. In addition to its natural beauty, Libya has remarkable historical sites, including the well-preserved Roman ruins of Leptis Magna and Sabratha, which are UNESCO World Heritage Sites. Libyan culture reflects a fusion of Arab, Mediterranean, and Berber influences, with traditional music, dance, and cuisine playing a central role.
Hello.
Hello, everybody. My name is Miss Grata. This is Mr. Joel. I'm from Ireland. We're going to sing a song today. We're going to start with an Irish song, Oscuelga, in Irish, and then we're going to sing a song by an Irish band. So I hope you enjoy it.
Oh,
India is the seventh largest country in the world and has over 1.4 billion people, making it the second most populous country. Hindi and English are the two main languages, but India has 22 officially recognized languages, showing its rich language diversity. The country's geography is very varied, with the tall Himalayan mountains in the north, dry Thar desert, and long coastlines along the Indian Ocean. India is the birthplace of many religions like Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, and Sikhism, showing its deep spiritual history. Indian food is famous for its strong flavors and spices. Popular dishes include biryani, a flavorful rice dish, dal, which is lentils, and roti, which is flatbread. Each region in India has its own special dishes like coconut curries in the south and tandoori kebabs in the north.
Hi, my name is Rama and I'm Egyptian. Egypt is a country with the most people in the Middle East. Its capital city, Cairo, has over 21 million people and is the second largest city in Africa. Egypt has the biggest Arabic-speaking population in the world and is important in history and culture. So the river, the Nile River, the longest river in the world, flows through Egypt and ends in the Mediterranean Sea. Most of Egypt is desert with a hot, dry climate, but the Sinai sometimes gets snow in winter. Egyptian culture is belly dancing being a big part of celebrations. Important holidays like Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha are times when families and communities come together. Egyptian food is tasty and filled with dishes like food medemis, stewed beans, kushari, a mix of rice, pasta and lentils, and flatbreads. Education is very important in Egypt, and teachers and scholars are greatly respected.
Saudi Arabia and Moroccans will go visit them.
gathering. The country also celebrates cultures with big festivals where people enjoy their music and art.
The Philippines. Known as the Pearl of the Orient Seas, the Philippines is an archipelago of more than 7,000 islands, each with its unique charm and beauty. From the pristine beaches of Boracay to the historic city of Manila, this country is a stunning fusion of nature and history. With a rich history and a diverse culture blending influences from East and West, the Philippines offers a unique and colorful heritage. Food lovers are sure to enjoy Philippine cuisines. Its favorites are adobo, lumpia, and halo-halo. The Philippines is also home to a warm and hospitable people renowned for their generosity and love for celebrations.
Russia, the largest country in the world, stretching across 11 time zones and two continents, Europe and Asia. Known for its rich history and diverse landscapes, Russia is home to majestic mountains, vast forests, and the famous Siberian tundra.
The country's cultural heritage includes world-renowned contributions in literature, ballet, classical music, and art, with greats like Tolstoy, Tchaikovsky, and the Bolshoi Ballet. Russia is also a nation of architectural wonders, from the iconic onion domes of St. Basil's Cathedral in Moscow to the opulent palaces of St. Petersburg. Belarus, a beautiful landlocked country in Eastern Europe, known for its lush forests, picturesque landscapes, and rich history. Often called the lungs of Europe, nearly 40% of Belarus is covered in forests, which are home to a diverse array of wildlife, including bison, bears, and lynxes. The capital city, Minsk, is a vibrant cultural hub showcasing impressive Soviet-era architecture, theaters, and museums. Belarus has a strong cultural heritage with a deep appreciation for folk music, dance, and arts, which are celebrated in festivals across the country.
So I invite everyone to stand up where you are, and I'm going to teach you the moves, and you're going to be joining us. The moves go arm, 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 shoulder, shoulder, head, head, hip, 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 and turn. Are we ready?
Including Malays, Chinese, and Indians. Festivals are very important in Malaysia, and big celebrations like Hari Raya and Diwali bring people together. Malaysian food is full of rich flavors, popular dishes including nasi lemak, coconut rice, satay, grilled meat on sticks, and rendang. Spicy meat. Malaysians are known for being kind and respectful, especially to their guests and elders. Showing respect to older people is a big part of daily life. Malaysia is also famous for its batik, a special way of making colorful pattern fabric that is loved all around the world.
Pakistan is a country in southern Asia where most people follow Islam, and it is an important part of their culture and way of life. About 96% of the people in Pakistan are Muslim. The national language is Urdu. Traditional clothing in Pakistan is called chalwar kameez, worn by both men and women. It is a long tunic with loose pants, and women often wear a scarf called a dupatta. Family is very important in Pakistan, and many families live together with grandparents, parents, and children all in one home. Cricket is the most loved sport, with people across the country cheering for their teams. Pakistani food is full of flavor and spices, with popular dishes like biryani, karahi, and chapli kebabs. These dishes are known for their rich taste and hearty ingredients.
Iraq is a country in southwestern Asia, in the Middle East. It is next to Turkey, Iran, Kuwait, and Saudi Arabia. Most people in Iraq follow Islam. The main languages spoken are Arabic and Kurdish. In Iraq, being kind to guests is very important. People often offer food and drinks to visitors as a way to show respect. Men usually wear a dish dasha, and women wear an abaya, which are modest, traditional clothes. Iraqi food is tasty and full of flavor. Popular dishes include masgouf, grilled fish, kuba, meat-stuffed bulgur, and dolma, stuffed vegetables, which are enjoyed during family meals and special celebrations.
There's a tree.
Thank you.
jam on this side. So grade four, come down this stairs. Where Miss Greta is, go this way. That stair's a little bit crowded. Okay, grade five, you can go ahead and head down the stairs with your teachers, please. Grade 7 and 8, go ahead and follow your teachers downstairs. And then parents, once all the students have made it their way down the stairs, you can come and join us on the first floor. Thank you so much.